With the rise of alternative plant-based milks and growing concern around climate change, the dairy industry has become villainized in the media. I caught up with Earl Ranson, a dairy farmer for over two decades, to hear about what it's like to be in his position during these supercharged times.
When I was in my teens, I was like, you know, I wanted to go as far away from farming as possible. And my dad had decided that he was going to sell the farm and, you know, basically retire. And I didn't really want to see that happen. So I decided to come back and run the farm.
You got a sweet spot for it then. Can you talk to me about what farming was like when you first started versus how it is now?
We've doubled in size in 20 years, but we've gone from being kind of the low end of average to being microscopically small.
Wow.
So the average size of a farm was about 80 cows. Now it's more like 300.
Oh my gosh. How much space do you need for 300 cows?
Somewhere between an acre and a half and 3 acres of land per cow. Some farms are operating with more like 5 acres per cow. It just depends on your feeding. So
wow.
My dad said when he started milking cows, there was like 12,000 dairy farms in the state of Vermont. And now there's like 600. The crazy thing is there's almost as many cows as there were then.
So that means there are people with a lot of cows.
Like thousands.
Okay, so now let's get into the difference of between like the small versus the large farm.
Well, I mean, the biggest difference is just in management. I mean, the amount of time that you can spend with an individual cow who has a problem, the care that's given to each cow is less. It depends on the farm. Some large farms have a lot of employees, but there is a limit. Even then, there's a limit to how many cows you can care for and how many cows you can know. You know, if I had more cows, at some point, you'd be like, oh, I don't really know that cow. But, you know, I have few enough cows that most of my cows I have some level of emotional attachment to.
People have a lot to say about the dairy industry. Why do you think that is?
There's an element of the dairy industry which has wanted to keep some of the things that we do because they were worried about people finding out. Because they were afraid that people would be uncomfortable with the part where a cow has to give birth in order to produce milk. What goes along with that is half of the calves that are born are male, and so they are raised for meat. And dairy didn't do a good job of being like, yeah, this is what we do. In addition to that, as farms have gotten bigger and bigger, the industry is still dependent on the image of small farms. So a lot of companies are selling an image that is no longer true. And there's reasons that the reality is different. And that reality can be managed in a way that is not horrible. In other words, those cows can be comfortable. Those cows can be well fed. They can be well taken care of. If that's the system that you want to use, be honest about it.
So let's get into the price of milk, because I understand it is, I mean, it's probably the most controlled agricultural commodity.
It's very much a government program driven price. The problem with milk is it goes up and down so much. Next month, the price might go down by $4 a hundredweight, or it might go up by $2 a hundredweight. You don't really know. And it's not really driven by any sort of local market. It's driven by this large agricultural agency that's somewhere else that is like deciding what the price is. I don't really understand it. I haven't participated in federal milk marketing for 20 years, and I gotta say, I don't miss it.
So I really want to talk to you about how milk is doing. Do you see people drinking less milk?
The statistics I've seen say that overall dairy consumption is about the same, but fluid milk is down like a big percentage, and then other products have taken up all that slack.
I definitely see that. As a chef, I can tell you for sure, people are eating cheese.
Yeah.
And talk about the impact of alternative milk.
So we haven't seen any drop in our milk sales. In fact, we've seen an increase in our milk sales. And that may be hyper-local. I think that Vermont consumes more fluid milk. Now, I know from talking to people in the grocery industry that they haven't taken up a huge percentage of the space in the markets that we sell to yet. It hasn't affected us yet.